We will solve the problem 54 of chapter 12. This is the arrangement. There is a wire supporting a rod of length L, and there are two masses. They can rotate about it, about its axis. So if I take a top view and take a cross section of the wire, this is the wire's cross section, and these masses are connected by a rod, and let this be the equilibrium position, and let there be a small displacement. I am showing it large just to magnify it, but this is actually a small displacement. Theta is given in clockwise direction. Now, because of this small displacement theta, there will be a restoring torque in the wire, and that torque would be equal to K into theta. This will try to bring it back. Now apply the equation of motion. Moment of inertia of system, let it be I, and d square theta upon dt square is the angular acceleration, would be equal to minus k theta. Now what is I in this case? I in this case is twice m into l upon 2 whole square is the moment of inertia. There are two balls, they're separated by from the axis distance is l upon 2. So be careful, take l upon 2 for each ball. So this is the moment of inertia, which comes as m l square upon 2 is the moment of inertia. Now apply this equation. M l square upon 2 is I, d square theta upon dt square plus k theta is equal to 0, or we can write it as d theta square plus twice k upon m l square into theta is equal to 0. This is the angular frequency, square root of angular frequency. We write it as omega 0, which will be twice k upon m l square under root is the angular frequency. Don't get confused with the angular frequency and angular velocity. Angular velocity will be omega, which is d theta upon dt. And angular frequency we have taken by omega 0. This is angular frequency. I am again repeating, don't get confused with the angular velocity. Now, suppose the maximum deviation was theta 0. This was the initial position. We take it by black. These are the balls. And this is theta 0. So due to this torsion, the energy which will be stored in the wire will be half k theta 0 square, like we do in case of the spring. This is the energy stored. Now this is the maximum energy, potential energy. Now when the wire loses it, it tries to come back, restores it to the mean position. At the mean position, the energy, potential energy stored because of torsion is 0, but this gets converted as the rotational energy, which is half I omega square. So at k theta 0 square is I omega square, or omega square is equal to theta 0 square k upon I. So this is one relationship which we have got. Put the value of I. Value of I was ml square. So theta 0 square k upon I is m L square into 2. So this is the value of omega square, which is square of the angular velocity. Now because of this angular velocity, there will be, now this is the axis. I am seeing the top view, it is rotating like this. It is at the mean position, and at the mean position omega square is given as theta 0 square k into twice upon m L square. We know because of angular velocity there will be one centrifugal force, which is mass into the radius is L upon 2 into omega square. So it will be m L upon 2 into omega square is theta 0 square k square 2 upon m L square. This gets cancelled, so it becomes m theta 0 square k square upon m L. Theta 0 square k, sorry, it is not k square, it is only simple k, and 2 gets cancelled. So we get m also gets cancelled. So the centrifugal force is theta 0 square k upon l is the centrifugal force. Now if you take again the side view, and this is the wire which was on which it was hanging. So we have got this force, which is theta 0 square k upon L, is the value of this force. There is another force which is acting, which will be mg. So the resultant force will be, because of these two, a vector addition of these two forces, somewhere like this. So the F resultant would be mg square plus theta 0 square k upon L whole square under root. So the resultant force which we have to find is m square g square plus k square theta 0 raised to power 4 upon L square whole raised to power 1 upon 2, and this is the answer.